Now talking about the center of gravity shift. This is a normal phenomena. Every person moves by walking. So while you're walking, you are actually placing your entire body weight on one foot, while you elevate the opposite foot off the ground to place it further anteriorly. This line of gravity, let's imagine what this person is doing. He is putting his right leg on the ground while he's lifting his left leg off the ground. So at that very moment of your gait stance, that the entire body weight is put on to the right limb. And remember, at this position the weight will be shared from medial condyle of femur to the medial condyle of tibia. Okay, but why is he able to elevate the opposite limb off the ground? The reason is because of the abductor mechanism of the gluteus medius minimus on the side of the leg on which he is standing. And remember, both these muscles are innervated by superior gluteal nerve. So when these two muscles on the side onto which he is standing, when they contract, they actually tilt the pelvis down here on that right side. At the same time, they elevate the pelvis on the opposite side. So doing so, they actually elevate the opposite limb off the ground. This way, you are actually, when you're running or you're walking, you do never realize this thing because of the abductor mechanism of the thigh. And that is by gluteus medius and minimus. Now look here, if this abductor mechanism gets paralyzed, maybe due to injury to superior gluteal nerve, or there are other conditions also which actually, you know, which might cause this Trendelenburg test to be positive, that might be dislocation of the hip joint, might be fracture of neck of femur and various other conditions. But while here, not right now, I'm talking is about the failure of abduction mechanism of the side onto which a person is standing. Let's say if there is right superior gluteal nerve damage, right gluteus medius, right gluteus minimus, they have actually paralyzed. Now if this person is trying to stand on the right leg, because this mechanism is paralyzed, they will not be able to, you know, contract and elevate the pelvis on the opposite side. So what happens is that pelvis droops down on the left side, and with that the person is not able to elevate his left leg off the ground, and that leads to limb lengthening in the opposite limb. So what happens is that this person, in order to place his left leg in front, what he does is he actually swings his limb, right? He actually, doing so, is actually, he brings this leg in front by swinging it in front. And because this limb, I told you, because of the drooping of the pelvis, this left limb will be more in length, therefore it will rub on the floor. So he swings it and places it, and at the same time, to compensate for this drooping of the pelvis, to elevate it and to maintain his balance, set the line of gravity passes through the same limb, single limb, which is on the ground. This person is have to tilt his torso or the trunk on the opposite side or onto the side onto which he is standing, so that this weight of the limb which is off the ground can be maintained within the line of center of gravity. At times you may even see some who are walking standing on single leg, they actually abduct the upper limb of that side so as to add up more of weight onto the side onto which limb is standing. So what happens is, because of the drooping of the pelvis, this pelvis has to be elevated, and for that the person tilts its body to the same side onto which he is standing. Here also this spine will be tilted like this. I hope you've understood this. And one more thing is, if let's say there is abductor mechanism paralyzed on both the sides, so what will happen when he'll stand on his left limb, again he will not be able to elevate his right leg off the ground. The reason is the abductors on the left side will also be paralyzed. So at this, another step with what will take is, like, now you're talking is bilateral abduction mechanism paralyzed. So he will have to like swing his right limb also to place it in front. So both the ways, if he's swinging his limbs to place it in front, and at the same time he will have to tilt his torso to the side to which he is standing. Like if he has to swing, if this there is abductor mechanism paralyzed to the right side, he will actually tilt his trunk to the right side and he will swing his left limb off the ground like this. So that is called a lurching gait, but the lurching will be to the right side. Now if he stands on the left limb and the left glute, you know, gluteus medius and minimus is paralyzed, so what will happen, he will now have to tilt his torso to the left side and he will have to swing his right limb off the ground to place it in front. So they will be lurching towards the left side. So if this happens bilaterally, now this will be called a waddling gait. Thank you.